Hey guys, it's Chris. From pets who inherited millions of dollars to the first dogs in space, here are 8 incredible animals whose achievements dwarf our own. Number 8. Pet inheritance. Let's face it, we humans always dream of having a lot of money to spend. I know I sure do. Even those who aren't vain want enough money to live well enough for the rest of their lives, and people work hard to make that happen. But for some pets, the only thing they needed to do to get rich was be cute and get picked by the right owner. There have been numerous cases of pet owners leaving their pets all kinds of vast fortunes over the years. Some have literally written in their will that the dog will have all the money and it can use it however they will, while others set up trusts in their pets' names and have responsible people looking after it and investing it wisely to conform to the owner and pet's desires. No matter what way you look at it, though, these pets got millions of dollars, and many aren't happy that this is actually a thing. One infamous millionaire actually left her money to her pet to spite her children, which led to a lengthy court case that did get the inheritance overturned, but at a great cost of money and a lot of time. And it's not just dogs and cats that have this happen. Michael Jackson gave $2 million to his chimpanzee Bubbles. One millionaire gave his fortune to his chicken, Jiju, and on the list goes. Would you leave millions of dollars to your pet? Let me know in the comments below. Number 7. Tama the Station Manager. In Japan, there is a small train station that was going through some tough financial times, to the extent that pretty much the entire staff within the station that would greet customers and help them out if they needed had to be laid off. This created a ripple effect that led to an unusual hire. You see, there were a lot of cats at that station, and they would get their food from the person who was the station manager most of the times. So the company who owned the station, in their infinite wisdom, decided to make one cat, Tama, the station manager, officially. They even gave Tama an outfit to show off the role. Her pay? Well, cat food, obviously. While no doubt a PR move of sorts, it worked. Over the course of a month, a bunch of new people came to the train station, mainly to see Tama. This in turn gave the company more profits, and they knew that they had Tama to thank. So they promoted the cat to super station manager, and the cat was even given some assistance via 2 other cats. But it doesn't stop there. By 2012, the success of Tama as super station manager led her to getting an office with the company, an actual human assistant, and a train painted in Tama's honor. Sadly, Tama died in 2015, but not before making an impact on the world. Number 6. Sir Penguin. Being knighted by an official country is a massive honor for anyone. So imagine giving that honor to a penguin. And this is not a hypothetical situation. This actually happened in Norway starting in 1987. A group of soldiers, specifically the Norwegian Royal Guard, was visiting Edinburgh Zoo when they came across a penguin. The group was no stranger to penguins, as they had actually adopted one as their mascot some time before. They called it Niels Olav I, but that penguin had died, unfortunately. Yet the penguin they were looking at in the zoo was the spinning image of him, so they decided to adopt him, but kept him in the zoo for his own health and protection. Now known as Niels Olav II, the penguin was given an honorary position in the Norwegian military. But as time went on and the Royal Guards returned to the zoo, Olav II kept getting higher and higher military honors. This included him becoming the Colonel-in-Chief of the Norwegian Army. Finally, in 2008, Olav II's services were so honored that the King of Norway himself allowed the Royal Guard to bestow upon this penguin the title of knight. This made his official title, get this, Sir Niels Olav II, Colonel-in-Chief of the Norwegian Army. And now for number 5, but first, if you're new here, be sure to subscribe to World List and click the notification bell so you don't miss out on the latest videos. Number 5. Cow Chase. Cows aren't the most respected of animals in the Western world, mainly because most people just see them as a source of meat and milk and not much else. But one cow in 2000 decided it wasn't going to end up like the others around it. The cow was on its way to the slaughterhouse along with others from its herd and must have sensed its fate. But one day, it leapt over a metal fence and made a break for it. You might think that the cow was caught quickly, but that wasn't the case. The cow actually evaded many people looking for it for a total of 11 in days. Remember now, cows are big creatures, and though they can run, they prefer not to. So the fact that it lasted that long out on the run is a pretty impressive feat. During this cow chase, word of what was happening had begun to spread to the nearby town of Cincinnati, Ohio. To the extent that the cow was even later named Cincinnati Freedom in honor of its great escape. But as you may have guessed, the cow was eventually caught. However, due to the public opinion and the press about the incident, the owners didn't feel it would be such a good PR move to kill the cow, so they released her to an animal sanctuary where she lived the rest of her days. Oh, and get this, the mayor of Cincinnati also gave the cow the key to the city. That is one successful cow. Number 4, protecting from harm. There are many stories about dogs who save people's lives. It's almost a part of their nature in some ways. But in regards to one pug named Pompey, he saved his owner in a very special way. Pompey was the dog of Dutch noble William the Silent. In the 14th century, the two were camping out in a tent. And then something caught the dog's ears. He heard someone coming ever closer to the tent. Reacting instinctively, the dog barked, but William didn't wake. As the footsteps got closer, Pompey decided more drastic measures were required and actually jumped on the face of his human friend. Well, that woke William up, and after seeing his dog in a panic, called for help, scaring the assassin away. The story is now legend in the country, which means it may not have been as accurate as it portrays. However, it had to start somewhere. Number 3, the space dogs. The idea of putting animals into space as test subjects has been documented in various ways over the years, but in truth, this was a vital part of the space race, as we had to know that animals could survive in space before doing tests with humans. Sputnik 2 was the first craft to ever put an animal into space, specifically a dog named Laika. Laika's journey into space was historic for numerous reasons, including her being the first life form launched from Earth into space successfully. And her journey paved the way for human space travel in more ways than one. Laika herself was astray before being picked up in the then Soviet Union. She was one of many dogs trained for the mission and then selected for the assignment. But it should be noted that the mission as a whole wasn't a full success. Laika died mere hours after launch because the craft wasn't fully prepared for the launch into space, and both her remains and the craft burned up upon re-entry. It is very sad to think about it, but many say her sacrifice was not in vain. The USSR learned from their mistakes with the first flight, and then got two more dogs, Belka and Strelka, and launched into space in 1960, nearly 2 years after Sputnik 2. Sure enough, they survived entry into space and even circled the Earth. The success of these three space dogs led the Soviet Union to launch human Yuri Gagarin into space in 1961. Then in 1969, the United States landed two men on the moon. Number 2, Hercules the Wrestling Bear. Bears are without a doubt one of the most fierce and powerful creatures on land. They're feared by humans and animals alike, and yet they also have the ability to learn skills in a way that boggles most people's minds. This was proven by a man named Andy Robin, who in 1976 purchased a grizzly bear from a zoo for only 50 euros. Andy himself was a wrestling champion, and he had the idea that he could teach the bear named Hercules to do various holds and tricks to make it seem like he was really wrestling with a bear. And it worked! Not only did Hercules learn the moves, he did them in such convincing fashion that he and Andy became worldwide sensations. Over the course of 25 years, they traveled the globe, did interviews, commercials, and of course they wrestled. Just as remarkable, scientists who had studied bears could not believe the calmness of Hercules, noting that nothing Andy did seemed to upset him. Hercules got so famous that he appeared in commercials, TV shows, movies, including a cameo in a James Bond film, and even did a stint with Bob Hope as a caddy. An injury caused his legendary career to end, but for a long time, Hercules was one of the most famous animals in the world. Number 1, the dog who inspired a nation. Now, how loyal is your dog to you? This question often relates to how well you treat your dog, or how well you train it, or both. But for one man, his dog, Hachiko, would show loyalty beyond the normal capacity for a dog. Heisabuto Ueno was a professor at Tokyo University, and he took the train to work every single day. Hachiko understood this, and so every afternoon, the dog would come to the train station and wait for his master to return. But in 1925, Ueno died while at work, so he didn't come home. Hachiko didn't know this, though, so the dog went to the train station and waited. The next day, the dog returned to the station and waited for his master to return. 9 years was how long Hachiko waited for his master to come back. Weirdly enough, one of Ueno's students found out what Hachiko was doing and got articles written about the dog. The people of Japan were moved deeply by this and honored Hachiko in many ways after the dog passed. The most famous of which is that there's a statue of him in the district of Shibuya. It stands as a tribute to honor, loyalty, and the love that that dog had for its owner. The story of Hachiko is still told to this day in Japan. In 1994, a record was found that had a recording of Hachiko, and it was played on Japanese television for people to hear. Millions tuned in to hear this legendary dog's voice. Well, thanks for watching, guys. What did you think of these incredible animals and their achievements? That Hachiko is something. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below, and be sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time.